I toss my pain with my wishes in a wishing well. I can't breathe, I'm waiting for the exhale. What's happening, guys? Chris here. So I'm kind of venturing across the lake, exploring new country. I'm looking for the backside of this drop. There's a hump I was working, and I never fished the backside of it, so I'm kind of working the backside of it. But kind of hit gold. I found a really nice weed bed out here in the middle of the lake. But there's pros and cons to fishing weed beds. There's always going to be big char in there. But the problem is when you hook these big char and they make those runs, they wrap around those weeds and you lose them quite a bit. But I figure, what the heck, we'll give it a shot. I'm going to throw the most expensive jig I got down there, but I figure we'll throw something down there that a big one would like to eat. And hopefully we bop one, huh? This is where one of those big pumpkins could come out of. Spot like this, sitting here getting fat on this weed bed on snails. Yet to mark a fish though. Maybe I just need to stay just above the weeds to bring them in, huh? We'll try that. All right, had a quick visit of the troopers. Thumbs up to you guys. Appreciate it, guys. Take care. Sinking tank. Under that oak out by the lake, written in stone. What's up, guys? So I am pretty excited. I actually I have always told myself I need to find this spot, or at least I haven't quite narrowed down the spot I'm after right now. But I've been working this hump, and I've always wanted to walk out and fish the backside of that hump, and I never do. And today I have done it. I went from 10 foot over there to about 38 foot right here. So pretty substantial drop in 50 foot, 50 length feet away from me. It's just an incredible drop right here. So my plan is, I'll probably stay out here. I was hoping that the fish would be a little bit more active and shallower. We got a pretty nice high pressure day today, but I really don't even know what the pressure is today. I haven't checked it. So I'm going to, I tried shallow earlier. Now I'm gonna go ahead and try deep, and the closer towards evening, I'm gonna start pushing my way in towards these weed beds I had located over here. That's only in about 7 to 10 foot of water, so. All these fish that are going to be out here chilling are going to eventually cruise in there, and it'll be a good place for them to look for food. I've only had 2 bites all day, and I'm pretty sure they were rainbow bites. They were up in shallow in about 5 to 7 foot of water. Oh, here we go. Better, huh? Actually, when he marked, yeah, he's a big fish. He's gonna drag up just a little bit. Nice fish. So the plan worked out well. Not in shallow, go deep. Not in the deep, go shallow. I'm about close to 40 foot right here. Coming up, maybe like a burbot. He hit it pretty quick. Haven't had any big runs yet. He's swimming up like a burb. Does feel pretty heavy, so I'm not putting a lot of tension on the mossy bubble. We got a burb. I got a quick release is what I got. That was a nice char, actually. Cool. All right. I see him shooting back down to the bottom here. No picture, but I got him in. Sorry for the long period of time I was away. My Vexlar had a broken wire and had to get that ordered up. I had a few doctor's appointments and all that good stuff to take care of. So I figured, we'll go ahead and get her all whacked in 1 week, and that way I can just get back to it and get back to it good. So I have all kinds of new plans for this week, or at least this month, is I'm going to do a night burbot fishing video. That's coming up here real soon. People are starting to drive on the lake. I'm going to give it a few more days before I drive on it, but that's going to make it a lot easier when I can drive. I can haul out the gear. I can haul out the tent and all that stuff. But yeah, I'm going to do that. I'm going to do a sight fishing video on a really cool rainbow lake. It has big rainbows. Doesn't have a whole lot, so I don't know how it's going to go. Could be an awesome day. Could be a bust, so... Got him that time. Man, it's just brutal cold out here. There's something to be really weird there. Alright guys, so I'm actually more excited now than ever, because I was expecting this hole to be right around 15 foot deep and I'm still in the 25 range, so that's pretty cool. That means that from where I'm at to that hole I drilled over there, it's 15 foot difference, and it's only about 18 feet over there, so pretty substantial drop here. It's gonna be a really good spot to focus this evening. I got a really good chance of getting a big fish off it. Keep your action. This tube is falling apart on me. I need to change that tube. I just need to change this whole rod set up all together right now. But yeah, still only at one rainbow, one char. One flipped off right at the hole, but I wasn't so mad because it's pretty cold out here today. I don't want to have the fish topside too long or at all if possible. I wouldn't really be so upset if they all flicked off at the hole other than that big boy. And that big boy, he's going to be coming out and going right back in very quick. So always pick and choose the days you go fish. And I was thinking it was warmer out here today, but with the wind chill, we got, we're probably pushing 0 degrees easy. Everything's icing up real good. Well, yeah, like I said, I'm excited. I'm just going to be pushing closer and closer to the structure as it gets closer to the evening. And hopefully pull a big fish. Got a mark here. Not to get rainbows right now. Okay. Bam! Oh, rainbow! jig down there so it doesn't freeze. Because it is brutally cold right now, guys. Not bad. I had that fish out and back in probably in about, I'd say, less than 20 seconds. So that's how it's done. Get them in and out, quick picture, bam, back in before those ice balls freeze, because you don't want to damage a fish for the rest of his life just to come out here and have a 20 second fight. All right, guys, I got a tank. Hopefully it fits through the hole. He is a stinking tank. I waited and waited for this fish. He is freaking strong. I turned him a little bit. Be my 30 inch, guys. This could be my 30 incher. Whatever I got is big. Whatever I got is big. Came loose. Came loose. I almost lost this fish, guys. I don't know how big the fish is. He's in a lot of weeds though. He's a fucking tank. He's a fucking tank! Oh my god! Whoa! Look at that fish! Look at you. Oh my god, guys, look at that fish. I can't even hold it. I gotta get him back in. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh my god. Go home. Woo! That's what I'm here for. Yes! Oh, I knew it was gonna be worth it waiting this cold out. Woo! That was a 28 inch fish, guys. I don't have a tape, and I wouldn't even dare put a beautiful fish like that on a board, but, oh, you see that fish? Oh my God, I love it. As I can't even tell you how I feel right now, it was just one of those rainbow days. The big ones weren't biting, but I mean, look at this, just piles and piles of weeds came up with that fish. I almost lost that beautiful fish, can you believe that? But smacked him on the green tube, 2-inch green tube. He wasted that thing. Man, what a beautiful fish. What a great way to end the day. My hands are freaking cold. It is cold today, guys. But man, I'm excited. That fish made my day. Hopefully it made y'all's. Hopefully it really gets you guys just wanting to hit the ice and have fun doing it. Hey, but first thing I want to tell you guys is let's really just manage these fish well. Especially this lake. This is a wild lake. These fish are not stocked. They will not be replaced. So if we kill these fish or we hurt these fish when we release them, that's it. This lake could die. So let's just always be very cautious of what we do and what we keep, especially out of a lake like this. There's tight restrictions on this lake anyway, but just not keep them out here. Let's keep the sport fishing fishery the way it is, because fish like that don't happen every day, you guys. And I want my kids to catch fish like that, and I want your kids to catch fish like that. So let's do a good job and manage our fisheries. And as always, thank you guys for joining me. And tight lines. And remember to hit like, subscribe, and share. All right, we'll see you soon.